In this podcast, we will look at Order 2, Rule 2, CPC and the salutary principle behind it. The salutary principle behind Order 2, Rule 2, CPC is that a defendant should not be vexed, troubled time and again for some cause, for the same cause, by splitting the claims and reliefs and filing successive cases. The provision provides that the plaintiff must not abandon any part of his claim except with the leave of the court. And if he abandons any part of his claim, either intentionally or by mistake, then he cannot file a new suit in respect of that abandoned or omitted portion of the claim. The principle behind Order 2, Rule 2 have been laid down by the Supreme Court in Kunjan Nair versus Narayan Nair, reported in AIR 2004 Supreme Court 1761, and Dalip Singh versus Meher Singh Rathi, reported in 2004 Volume 7 SEC 650. To fully understand Order 2, Rule 2, we must know exactly what a cause of action is. A cause of action is a bundle of facts which, when taken with the applicable law, gives the plaintiff a right to relief against the defendant. This is the explanation given by the Supreme Court in Swami Atmananda versus Sri Ramakrishna Tapovanam, reported in AR 2005 Supreme Court 2392. There are many examples of when a subsequent suit will be hit by Order 2, Rule 2 and when it will not. I will consider a few examples. In a suit for possession of property, mean profits is not asked for. A subsequent suit was filed for mean profits. It was held that the bar of Order 2, Rule 2 would not apply. This is for the reason that it is settled law that the cause of action for mean profits from the date of decree till delivery of possession is different from the plaintiff's cause of action for possession. This was the view taken by our High Court in Gaurava versus Hanuma Gowda, Basappa, Kodi Gowda, reported in ILR 2005 Volume 4 Karnataka 4971. Where a plaintiff and agreement holder filed a suit for bare injunction without seeking leave of the court to later file a suit for specific performance. The purchaser cannot maintain a suit for specific performance as it would be barred by Order 2, Rule 2. The vendor, defendant, can however sue for ejectment of the purchaser or any third party who is in possession of the property. This is also a decision of the Karnataka High Court in Jairam versus Lakshmi, reported in ILR 2005 Volume 4 Karnataka 4862. In order that a plea of the bar of a suit by Order 2, Rule 2 should succeed, the defendant who raises that plea must make out a case that the second suit was in respect of the same cause of action. The principle of constructive res judicata is set out in Explanation 4 to Section 11 of the Code of Civil Procedure applies in cases falling under Order 2, Rule 2, CPC. Mysore Kirloskar versus ESIC, reported in 1999 Volume 1 Karnataka Law Journal 115. When a defendant pleads a bar under Order 2, Rule 2, it is incumbent upon him to produce the pleadings in the earlier suit. Again, Karnataka High Court, Narasahalli Kempanna Narasappa versus Narasappa, reported in ILR 1998 Volume 1 Karnataka 179. And Venkata Gowda versus Shivane Gowda, 1990, Volume 1, Karnataka Law Journal, 134. Order 2, Rule 2, cannot be used when there is an earlier writ petition and a subsequent suit. This is the law laid down by the Supreme Court in AR 1965 Supreme Court, 1153. The importance of Order 2, Rule 2 is that all the reliefs which the plaintiff is entitled to ask on a particular cause of action should be asked for. And if for some reason is not being asked for, an application should be made seeking leave of the court to file a separate suit in respect of that portion not asked for.